This tutorial is going to demonstrate how to do a Wilcoxon signed rank test on paired samples in R. The Wilcoxon signed rank test on paired samples is a non-parametric alternative to the paired samples t-test. So basically it's for comparing paired data. It's particularly recommended in a situation when the data is not normally distributed. An example of not normally distributed data is demonstrated on the graph on the right. And as you can see, the data does not look like a bell-shaped curve, which typically represents normal distribution. When doing a Wilcoxon test, the sample size should be at least 6, otherwise you may struggle to find a significant result. So the first thing we need to do is install and load packages we need for this tutorial. So to install a package, you simply type install.packages and then in brackets and quotation marks, the package name. And then to load them, you just type library and in brackets, the package name. Remember on R that you only have to install a package once and your R environment will remember it. But each time you want to use it, so for example, when you start a new script, you need to load it in using the library function. For this tutorial, we are going to use the mice2 data from the data-rem package that we have just loaded. And this data set is the weight of 10 mice before and after treatment. The first thing that we need to do is transform this into long data, and then we can view it using the view function. So you can do this by using the following code. And remember that view has a capital V. So here is our data. And it's now in long format where all the groups are in one column and the ID is repeated however many times. So to break it down, firstly, we have the ID and this is our mice. As you can see, the numbers are repeated because it is within subject's design. Then we have our group, which is before and after treatment. And finally, we have the weight. So the Wilcoxon test assumes that the difference between paired samples should be distributed symmetrically around the median. So to look at this, we firstly need to compute the differences between pairs using the following code. And then we can create a histogram using the GG histogram function, like this. So here is the histogram that that code produces. And as you can see, the differences between pairs are approximately symmetrical. Remember that it does not have to be perfect. So now we are ready to do the Wilcoxon test. And we can run a Wilcoxon test to answer the question, is there any significant change in the weights of mice before and after treatment? And we can compute the Wilcoxon test by using the Wilcoxon test function, where the general formula is Wilcoxon test, and then in brackets, the dependent variable, a tilde, the independent variable, and not forgetting to tell R that paired equals true, as this is a within subject's design. And here is the formula for R dataset. So as you can see, we have our dependent variable, which is weight, and our independent variable, which is group. And we have also told R that paired equals true. And here are our results. As you can see, there is a significant change in weight before and after treatment. You can see this by looking at our p-value here, which is less than 0.05. But please remember to check if your supervisor has different cutoff points. We can also use R to compute the effect size. And we can do this by using the Wilcox effect size function like so. The rest has the same formula as what was on the previous slide. And here are our results. As you can see, there is a large effect size, which is demonstrated in this column here. Finally, here is the full script from this tutorial that you can use and have a go yourself with.